I'm invited. We are so happy to have you here today. As you know, our pastor, Lissa, is unable to be here, so I will be conducting the service today. And before we start, we just ask if, in order for us to create the appropriate video, we need to have you turn off your phones and turn off the Wi-Fi and put your cell phones on silent. We appreciate that. And I know we have at least a couple of announcements. Susan, you want to start us?
First off, my welcome as well. Please keep our church secretary, Tammy Taylor, in your prayers. I don't have full confirmation, but she has all the symptoms and was exposed to COVID over the New Year's holiday and has been out all week. And therefore, I got to do the bulletin. Who knew that there was some green paper mixed with the white? So some of you were blessed to have a green. And you know, you have the opportunity to stay awake because when you turn the page, you've got to flip it upside down. Within the office to keep things moving along. So we may have to do this again, and if somebody knows how to do this. Because I've been into Word, I have no idea how to even get into the publishing software. So I appreciate that. And you know, there may be an announcement from Lynn about what is around our beautiful sanctuary, making it even more beautiful. But I have to say, I was just talking with T. She and I had the opportunity to visit San Juan pre-COVID, January 2020. And the wise men are like sacred saints to them. And all their art, I mean, we were there in January, and just everywhere you went, and any artisans, and they had a street fair going on. Everything was around the three wise men. So maybe there's a little Puerto Rican for you, Lynn, but beautiful, beautiful. Thank you.
Yes, I saw a number of you walking around looking at the beautiful little statues of the ones up front, and they were brought here by Lynn Boy, and we asked Lynn if she could just say a few comments about them. So Lynn.
That's my obsession, and I apologize, but I hope you enjoy all the different types of medium that are representative. Thanks.
announcements before we start the service. Dolores?
Flowers today are in honor of our three new members. So Lynn Coy, I'd like you to take the flowers home today, please.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dolores.
And Ron.
Yes.
There's an announcement in that bulletin about the Bible study that we were beginning. And it's going to start on January the 23rd. And it is a Adam Hamilton study on Simon Peter. We're going to do it at 8:30 in the morning here on Sundays, from 8:30 until 10. So invite you to consider that. We will be publishing Evelyn's phone number. Evelyn and I are going to co-teach this. So that you can sign up, so that we can make sure we have enough materials for everybody. So watch for further information. Hopefully it'll be out within the next week or so in terms of how to sign up for the class. Thank you.
All right. Okay, we'll now begin our service with our prelude by our music director, Dan Fedorovic.
Thank you.
seated. Please join now in our prayer of confession. God, our Savior, we confess that we fail to live in our lives. Christ has come to the world, and yet we do not know. He has called us to be his own, and yet we do not accept him. Forgive us, God, of grace. Shape us by your word of truth. Seal us with your Holy Spirit, and let us live to show your glory through Jesus Christ our Lord. The good news is that Christ calls us to new life and enables us to begin again and again and again. My friends, believe the good news of the gospel. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Our two scripture readings today, the first is taken from the Old Testament from Isaiah, and the second from the Gospel of Luke. From Isaiah. But now thus says the Lord, he who created you, O Jacob, he who formed you, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. And when you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. Because you are precious in my eyes and honored, I love you. Fear not, for I am with you. I will bring your offspring from the east and from the west. I will gather you. I will say to the north, give up, and to the south, do not withhold. Bring my sons from afar, and my daughters from the end of the earth, everyone who is called by my name, whom I created for my glory, whom I formed and made. The word of the Lord. The second reading on this day as we celebrate the baptism of Jesus is taken from the Gospel of Luke. The people were waiting expectantly and were all wondering in their hearts if John might possibly be the Messiah. But John answered them all, I baptize you with water, but one who is more powerful than I will come, the straps of whose sandals I am not worthy to untie. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fork is in his hand to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his barn, but he will burn up the chaff with unquenchable fire. When all the people were being baptized, Jesus was baptized too. And as he was praying, heaven was opened, and the Holy Spirit descended on him in bodily form like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my son, whom I love. With you I am well pleased." The word of the Lord. We will now hear from the choir an anthem, "Bring We the Frankincense of Our Love." If you would like to follow the words, it is found in hymn number 62 in our hymn list. I'd like to share some thoughts with you today about baptism and our commitment to God. We celebrate the feast of baptism of Jesus today, and it has always been a little bit of confusion about what we celebrate at the Epiphany. For the Eastern Church, Epiphany is celebrated as the baptism of Jesus, as we heard this morning in the reading from Luke. And we saw a symbolic representation of this past Thursday. The Greek Church, which is part of the Eastern Church, celebrates a throwing of a cross into the bayou. Some 50-some-odd boys will jump into the waters, symbolic of baptism, to retrieve that cross. And it was thrown in by the Archbishop. For the Western Church, however, for our church, Epiphany celebrates the arrival of the three kings. Thanks to Lynn for reminding us of that. The Magi will bring gifts to the Christ child. They bring gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. Either way, Epiphany means a manifestation. It is the presentation of the Son of God, Jesus. Now, Epiphany can also mean a moment when we suddenly feel that we understand something. We have an epiphany. It's an awakening. Jesus didn't have to be baptized. He is baptized not to repent for sins, but to establish a relationship that shows that he belongs to God and is called to do God's work in our world. And this is the meaning of our baptism. It is the rite of initiation into the life that God wants of us. It is meant to be a life-changing commitment. So whether we have been baptized or just committed to Christ, what is important is that Jesus is made manifest in our world, in our lives, and he calls us to follow him and to do his work today. You know, it's not enough just to believe in God. We have to take it to the next step. We have to do something, take action. We don't become more organized simply by purchasing a file cabinet. We don't become more healthy just by joining a gym. In each case, we have to make a decision inside and then take it to the next step. Start the action that drives the change. And that's what makes all the difference. The Christian life works the same way. We can't change what we do and think somehow that that's going to change our heart. It won't work. We have to first change our hearts. God always works from the inside out. Christianity is a religion of the heart. And so it is with our God. First, we believe in him, and that drives us to be in relationship with him. And in that relationship, we have to give up some control and let him take the lead. He's promised to be with us every step of our lives, and each day we have to learn to trust and follow him no matter where he leads us. And he is the God of new beginnings. Jesus stepped into our earthly world, and he experienced hunger and thirst and pain and suffering and exhaustion and so much more. He experienced what we go through in our lives. And he chose to reside with us, to live with us, to put on our skin, so to speak. And that's what God is all about. He steps into our daily life with our joys, our struggles, and he's with us in the midst of it all. He's alongside of us in the fray of things, and he sustains us by his grace. You know, after Jesus rose from the dead, the ordinary men and women who followed him had an epiphany, and they were suddenly doing very extraordinary things. The lame beggar began his usual day by panhandling and lying in the dust outside the temple. He ended his day by walking like a new man, leaping and praising God. Peter, the one who questioned his role as an apostle and three times denied that he was one of Jesus' followers, he's now healing the lame and preaching sermons and converting thousands to Jesus. You see, there was a major change inside their heart and mind that enabled them to transform others, to empower others. And it came from inside, a conviction of faith and trust in Jesus. And God created us to be amazing people, to do extraordinary things. He wants a new you who not only looks different, but who lives different and thinks and speaks and acts differently. In this new year, he wants us to take a 180-degree turn and move in a new direction, transformed by the renewing of our heart into the likeness of Christ, a new beginning. And where is he leading us? He tells us, love God with all your heart and love your neighbor as yourself. We need to give whatever help we can to those who are suffering, especially during these times. When all the chips are down, when a dear friend is getting divorced and his or her life is upside down, when one of our children is struggling to settle into life, when a loved one is very sick and may not make it through, he wants us to be there for them. He leads us to them and asks us to be his hand of love and support, his healing touch. But first, we have to take care of ourselves, and then we can move on. He spoke to us today in the reading from Isaiah, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine because you are precious in my eyes and honored. I love you. Fear not. I am with you. A number of years ago, a 9-year-old girl was selected to sing the national anthem at a professional ball game on national TV. She started to sing, but after the first couple of lines, she forgot the words and stopped singing. How embarrassing for her. But what happened next was a wonderful outpouring of love and support. Everyone in the stadium began singing for her. Slowly, you could hear more and more people joining in and singing for her until the entire stadium was singing. And then she remembered the rest of the words and resumed her solo. It took the innocence of a child and her little mistake to bring out the stuff of our ordinary lives and create hope and togetherness, a community of love and compassion, even among the thousands of people who were there to root against each other. For these few minutes, they united together to help a little girl finish her solo. Being a baptized Christian simply means using the gifts and the talents and the skills we have been given by God for the good of others and for ourselves. It's a process where God takes the stuff of our ordinary human experience and makes it extraordinary. He uses it to create and save and give hope. Nothing is unusable by God. He uses everything and everybody as material for his work, which is the remaking of the mess we sometimes make of things. He is the God of a second chance, the God of a new beginning. Coincidentally, during the Epiphany season, specifically on January 15th, we celebrate the birthday of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. He was called a dreamer, much like Joseph in the Old Testament, who was sold by his brothers. They said, here comes the dreamer, let's slay him, and then we'll see what comes of his dream. Well, both Joseph and Dr. King had hope, and their hope empowered their lives and transcended their own situations. They had a vision of what God has in mind for his creation, a bold vision of a new heaven and a new earth where there will be no more weeping and no more injustice and no more oppression or cruelty or persecution, no more unkindness and meanness, no more war. A world where God will tenderly wipe the tears from the eyes of his precious suffering children, whoever they are and wherever they are. And our vision must be the same. No matter how deep the darkness or the evil that surrounds us, the great light of hope is there, and we can choose whether to receive that light and walk in that light and spread that light, or whether to hide from it and place obstacles in its way. We're here to be the light, to bring out the God colors in the world. God is not a secret to be kept. Through our baptism, we have been put on a lampstand. Now we have to shine. The theologian Richard Rohr puts it this way: at Christmas, at the new year and Epiphany, God is waiting for us to wake up. It's as if we are asleep in the manger and not Jesus. Jesus is alive in our midst. And what if we're in the manger and God is already in our midst and we're so asleep, so unconsciously asleep, that God is sort of looking for someone to get up and help bring his gifts into the world? Let's awaken to what God is doing in us and what God is seeking us to become. A friend of mine sent this to me. He said, as the world fights to figure everything out, I'll be holding the door for a stranger, letting people cut in front of me in traffic, saying good morning, keeping babies entertained in the grocery line, stopping to talk to someone who's lonely, being patient with the sales clerk, and smiling at a passerby. Why? Because I will not stand idly by and live in a world where love is invisible. He says, join me in showing kindness and understanding and judging less. Be kind to a stranger. Give grace to friends who are having a bad day. And be forgiving of yourself today and every day. He says, be the change, be the light. Let us start today and never stop. Let it be so among us. As you are able, please stand as we sing hymn number 66, We Three Kings.
Thank you.
requests that anyone has? Susan?
Prayers for the Sterling family, for Andrea, Carolyn, and Larry. Marlene.
Prayers for our Jack.
For whom?
Our Jack.
Jack. Yes. Yes.
Rob and Andy.
And what was the first one?
Rob.
Bob. And Andy. Pray together. Caring Father, we thank you for your love, a love that seeks us, a love that finds us, and a love that rejoices over us. We pray today for those who are depressed or lonely, who cannot see the value of their lives or the warmth and the love they have shared with so many. We pray that we would be the vehicle to communicate your love to them, and that they would once again want to live and feel your presence in their lives. You sent Jesus to live among us. He was moved to compassion for the poor and the powerless, for the sick and the sinner. By his words and actions, he proclaimed to the world that you care for us all, as a father cares for his children. Help us to go and do the same. And bless this community of faith who give hope to the lost, who bind up wounds and bring comfort to those who hurt and mourn. We pray this morning for the millions of families who are hurting with the COVID vaccine, virus, hunger, and joblessness. Bring comfort and help to them, to those whose lives have been turned upside down by the loss of a loved one. Bless them, Lord. Give them strength and hope. And for all who serve others, going out of their way to help your voiceless children, bless the work of their hands, multiply the work of their hands. Guide the people of this land and of all nations in the ways of peace. We pray for peace in our world. We pray for those in positions of public trust that they would serve justice and promote the dignity and the freedom of every person. Give us a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly, that the world may be free from poverty, famine, and disaster. We commend to your mercy all who have died, especially those from this congregation, and bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours. Now, Lord, for all who have asked for our prayers, we Joe and Rick for Marlene, for Jack, for Allison and Mike and Norma, for Brenda and Daniel, who have COVID, for Jack, for Lo and Elaine, for Jordan and Sarah, for Bob and for Andy. We pray for the families and the children of all whose family members have died from COVID. We pray, Lord, for our families and friends and neighbors that they might live in joy and peace and good health. Lord, hear our prayers. And now, Lord, please hear our prayers as we pray together the prayer that you have taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. We will now have our offertory collection. Our ushers will pass the collection plate. We ask you to remember that God loves a cheerful giver, and he also accepts from the grouchy.
Reading from 2 Matthew. Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? We have seen the star of the east, and we have come to worship him." Worship of him.
Thank you.
now, my friends, may the Lord bless and keep you and make his face shine on you and give you peace. As you remember the child born in Bethlehem, may you also remember to honor the child in your own heart. May you follow the light of the stars in your dreams and know that God is with you wherever you go. Let the hope that was born in a stable be a sign that God can change the world through one small child. May the spirit of Christmas warm our hearts all year long. And now may the blessing of Almighty God, God who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with us all now and forever. God bless you. Please join us for some refreshments in the fellowship hall, and we'll catch you next week.